Hey Scorpio, happy birthday. It's your season. And this transition from Libra to Scorpio season, right? So different. For some people, including some of you, you might feel like a little fatigued, but it's only because it's from cardinal to fixed energy. So we went from the very obviously fast-paced go, 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 where some people were extremely tired still last month, and now hitting your season could feel like a wall for some people, even for some of you, just to get into it. And for you this month, there's still a focus. So we go from the season of relationships to the season of deeper intimacy, right? So you come into your season a lot clearer. And it's really important for you to, this month, be extremely clear and let yourself get clear. So I know for some of you, because when you get really clear and because when you know what you want, you then have to take the steps towards it, and you don't feel like you have the energy right now. You will. You'll have the energy to do it. And that's why it will be important that when those moments arise and you want to think about or contemplate the future and the work that will also go into this future, for some of you, because you, some of you can sway, this is perfect, some of you can sway to one end of things where it's all passion and purpose for you. That's all it's about. That's all you want to do, nothing else. And for some of you, your job is for a check. It's for that money because you like to have that security of money. So this month, those of you who are on that side of the spectrum, we'll get a chance to dive into your mind and dive into this different side of yourself, this mysterious, the creative place of the mystery of even being curious about what might your passion or purpose will be or what it may be. And it may even come very serendipitously to some of you who you just try something new, or a friend asks you to do something, you do something, and then all of a sudden you're obsessed and you want to do it and you want to keep doing it. It'll be good for you. Any interest that you gain this month, or skill that you feel interested in this month, go all for it, go into it. And what it will reveal to you, we have the Chariot, so 10 of Wands, 9 of Wands, and then the Chariot, is that once you get really clear on what it is that you do want to put your energy into, whether it is making more money. And for those of you who are on that side of the spectrum where you're all passion and purpose, money is going to start coming to you more now than ever. Your season, you're already a very magnetic creature. In this season, you're going to be able to pull most of anything that you want to. And that's why you also need to be careful, about your intentions. So using the full moon cycles is a great, or using the moon cycles is a great way to put that into action, to write it out, do any kind of ritual that might be helpful for you. And because we're in the season of, you know, the deeper mystery of things, we're getting into spooky season, you can even light a candle and kind of sit with it and see what happens with that. And that might be good for some of you. It might feel really good for some of you. This month, you're going to feel more, a lot of you are going to feel so much more in your zone, so much more in yourself, in a way that you feel at home. The discomfort has come for some of you that are entering the season feeling a little more tired. It's from the discomfort of having to put up different boundaries last month, of having to, even just within yourself and in your mind, so that you know, for some of you, and that takes more energy out of us. And then for those of us who are more psychically attuned, this past month has been a crazy uplifting and up-leveling. That's what I mean. So the deal with that is, when you, whether you're aware of it or not, there's going to be some type of shedding or fatigue where you need to sleep more. You need to adjust to what's going on. And for some of us, it was because we were adjusting. Each sign is preparing for the next sign. We are adjusting to get ready for your season. Last season was all about, you know, all up here, the thoughts, the replays of what has happened, what will happen in relationships, and all these different aspects of our lives. And now we get into the deeper mystery, the intimacy in your month, where it gets very clear that where we can't hide from our insecurities, our doubts, our fears, whatever it is, it will show up. Like last month, It showed up. But this month, it's more clear. It's sharper. You know, when you edit an image or you look at an image, what does it become? It becomes sharper. They want the sharpest version of the image, a mirror. A mirror is sharp. If it breaks, it will cut you, right? So this month, some people will feel, and you will be extra, especially in the beginning, especially when Mars moves into your sign on the 30th. That's also this Ace of Swords, King of Swords. Your words. For some of you, you're gonna unleash. It won't be like I'm starting a war. It'll just be in different situations in your life and you're just kind of like, fuck it. I did a fuck you finger this month. Just like, fuck it. For some of you, just fuck it. You're like, I've done what I had to do. I put in this time, I put in this work. And what's revealing to you is a very prosperous road ahead of you. And a lot of you are gonna feel extremely independent this month. Some of you though, in the act of intimacy in your relationships, you'll notice why certain patterns have come up in that area of your life and why and what you want. And you'll be more clear about what you want now for yourself. A lot of you are thinking long term. And I think that's important because when you're, this doesn't happen for everyone, but when you're in a place where things are just happening and you're in that abundance and you're really on fertile soil and treading fertile ground and doing things and making things better, bigger, more abundant for yourself, passion, purpose, everything starts aligning. So I guess just be, if for those of you who are not partnered, just be very cautious because it is, it's sexy time month. It's sensual month. It's everything. It's like you want to feel all up in your vibe this month. And yeah, so is everyone else. We want to be in that Scorpio vibe, but not everyone wants to take what Scorpio has season will have to say or do or what they'll experience. And for you, you're all for it. You're here for it. You're wanting it. Just remember that just like you don't really, for some of you who don't really like Libra season, by the time we get into like, you know, the second half of your season, even you sometimes are like, okay, enough. You won't feel this way this month. Why? You're just a lot more balanced in who you are. For those of you who aren't, and for those of you who tend to tip the other way, it may be really important for you to be very aware of the boundaries that you put up from last month, or whatever that you had to get really clear and certain about, and decisions you had to make. Remember those things. There's nothing wrong with remembering certain decisions or things that made our lives better, make your life better for you. And what it will reveal to you is that how far you've come from situations that you've dealt with in the past. And you might even have situations that come up that are very similar, but you feel very confident moving forward. You feel very confident and you know what to do. And you're ready to make those moves. Again, when you're setting that vision for like that passion and purpose, it can feel very big. And like sometimes even you, someone who is so powerful, someone who is so naturally psychic and skilled in that way, it can feel overwhelming. This month for you though, as long as you're clear and like you're coming into this month really even just your sharpest, having the sharpest image of yourself, those steps become very easy because they become pulled towards you. Now just remember, wherever you're coming from, you're going to pull that energy towards you. So because of that sharper image this month, that sharper mirror, that will be the name of your reading. You don't want to pull more bullshit. So if you have an opportunity where it seems scary, because you've been stable, maybe making money, or you've been in your passion or purpose, you don't want to give up certain freedoms maybe that you have, it's time to be more disciplined in that, and maybe be more disciplined in whatever opportunity, because for some of you, there will be an opportunity that comes to you, and it seems like, it can seem scary, but I think it's important for you to very much consider it. Maybe don't make any rash decisions. You're not advised here to make any rash decisions, but definitely ask questions, get more clear about it, and it will help bring out more of what you got clear, or what you're getting clear on from the beginning of this month, especially for those of you who have that a little bit of doubt, or you don't know exactly what it is yet. For those of you who do, there will be an opportunity you'll have to take, but there will be work involved where you'll have to, in order to make money, you have to give up a little time over here. You'll have to create specific space for this passion and purpose. For some of you, though, that passion and purpose is going to draw you in that money. For some of you, it's just going to really take off. And this month, remembering that it's okay to be extreme, but I say to, like, the transitions of the month, just make sure you're taking care of yourself and getting the sleep and the rest that you need. You're a water sign. When you get sick, you really get sick. So, you know, just that extra take care of yourself this month, even if things are going well and you have this to do, that to do, that to make sure that just as much as, like, you like to spend your time or take your alone time throughout the rest of the seasons, this month is also very important as well. Because what's going to come up is that you'll realize there'll be certain places where you didn't think that you would be called stagnancy or feeling stuck in, but you'll realize that there are other things that come along with when you're moving forward into these different directions, because it will be a little bit uncomfortable, but you're so ready for it, because, like, you're so just, this season for you is so much about you being, like, exactly you. It's like everything's finally got weird and crazy enough where you can be weird and crazy enough and it feels fucking normal. So that might feel weird and crazy, but you're happy about it. So create the structure that you need. For some of you who need to get to work, because you're going to make the monies too, so that will make you feel like, oh wait, this is no problem, I want to do this anyway. Some of you are going to be really pleasantly surprised by the situations you find yourself in this month, because not only the way you handle things, because some of the win is about how you handle things, actually. And some of you, it is the exact opportunity that is being presented to you. It's just how the opportunity presents itself, and what it is. And it's just a lot more movement. I think last month for some of you, it felt like this repeat, maybe this song that repeated, just kept going back and forth for you, the retrogrades, you know. This month is very much clear, ready. Okay, I think I'm going to leave that behind now and take things forward. And it's very much about you. Like, yeah, there are people in your life, and there will be people in your life. There will always be people in your life, and people who want to get closer to you and who want more from you. But you're kind of just in this, again, this fuck it place where, like, you don't care enough to acknowledge or be around people who, you know, it's only for your season. You really want to be in that fuck it place where you don't have to really explain yourself, feel like you're being scary or anything like that, or being misunderstood. You want, and again, I know you like being in those places sometimes, and you will be misunderstood. Not everyone will understand you, but you'll feel, there's something about feeling at home this month, very much home in your skin. And I, more than anything, I would say that's amazing. Is it not? All right, Scorpio, we'll take a look at your cards, which will be in the next part of this reading. And all information to work with me one-on-one is below. All the payment options are there as well, okay? I'll see you next month. Hi, Scorpio. It's so funny. I feel like I have to keep, I don't know. I learned something after I recorded the second part the first time, so this is the second time I'm recording this. Okay, so this is, like, the different things that came to me. So first of all, you're entering the season feeling extremely clear, but extremely sharp, like, a mirror. You feel there may be this tendency to be extremely focused and clear on what you've set in motion because you know how hard you've worked. So again, don't be afraid to use that fuck you finger. Don't be afraid, like, that sword, all these swords are like, yo, don't be afraid to be like, fuck you. And part of you may feel cold. I mean, it is the month of death, no? Even though death isn't initially cold. But I think that's just a sign for you that when you feel cold around somewhere, you feel like you just feel icy, you know intuitively that
you need to get out of that situation, or that it's like a protection that comes up for some of you. So that's really specific. But a lot of you are, you've cleared a lot of space for yourself. And it's mental clarity that you're coming, like that this is, that this month is very much showing you that how mentally stable you've become, but you, and you're going to need it, because this season may get very frustrating. The iciness, the air ice, the combo, cold wind. And you know, but you know how hard you've been working. You know how hard internally you've been working with certain things that you know just aren't the move anymore, the different things that are being revealed to you because of that, the power that's being revealed to you because of that, and you're going to want to use it this month more than ever, and it's just really important that you are wise about it, because when the sword's in your hands, how do you, so are you, you've done all of this work, and then you have a sword in your hands, and then what? Because Mars is moving into Scorpio too, so naturally your ego, depending on which way it goes for you, can be, is going to be heightened, and your words become sharper, your intuition is extremely clear. So, and as we know, words can become venom and they can hurt people, as you know more than ever and more than anyone. And you've realized that you don't have to explain, and this month would be a great month not to feel like you have to explain yourself, but to those that you just let unleash on, I mean, let's just say that we pray for them now. And it's kind of like you might be the repercussion for some people, like some people may run into you, and whatever happens is some type of repercussion from them, and some of you will get that. What happens for a lot of you, even though this is a lot of mental focus, because you know you want to go out, you want to be sexy, you want to have fun, you want to do all the things, and you want to be like your mysterious self who, you know, does certain things, but there's a side of you that you have more than ever acknowledged that is better off tamed for the sake of keeping up what's been happening. And especially for those of you who not only want to continue to make money and really break through on that with doing what you love and having passion and purpose behind you, those of you who have been making the money, like I said in the beginning, and are finding passion and purpose through that focus, and it just reveals itself to you through situations and maybe through scenarios, or maybe it came up through in Cancer season and is now revealing itself again. It might be through a Cancer or a situation with them. But they may quickly exit the situation and then you come in and you stay and things work really well for you. But there will be a part of you that you may feel frustrated about something. Maybe that if you, you know, I know that a lot of us get, and I say us, I just have a lot of Scorpio in my chart, but a lot of Scorpios can, you guys can get upset because you feel like you should have known something or known better. Like, why didn't I realize this then? And that's not what this is about. It's not that time to get icy cold on yourself. It's just knowing that whatever's showing up now more than ever is just showing up so that you can follow the lead. And that, again, we go back to that Mars being in Scorpio, Venus being in Sagittarius. Be careful of your ego. Be careful how you use the magnetism and the power that's coming to you more than ever this month. Why? Well, because it's going to, you have the Chariot behind you with all of this energy and this easy access to the flow. The more that you keep that stable mental boundaries, because some of you, it's mental boundaries with not getting overly, like, definitely be obsessed with things that, like, allow your obsessions freedom for sure. And at the same time, some of you really just are so focused on what's important to you right now. For some of you, you may find a partner in the work field or in the situation that you, or the opportunity that will be presented to you throughout the month. And some of you may meet someone who's completely on the same page with you. For those of you who are partnered, you may find that you're talking more about marriage, and you find that your intimacy with one another gets deeper through what you have learned to say yes and say no to, through how you've learned to relate to each other in this past interesting month of Libra season. So this season comes in and we're just like hit this wall of water. but there's so much air and there's so much still intact that has yet to kind of not be so intact by the end of the month. And once we get into December, this month will probably feel quick for you. So it's best that you find those moments of presence. And when you do find those moments of presence, that you give yourself full permission to be there and to experience that, because you're going to realize more and more as you become attuned to this very psychic nature, to this very intuitive, sensitive nature that you are, that this month is going to get weird. And even you're going to look around and be like, yeah, this is getting weird. It's like, now that everyone's like weird, or it feels like so open about being themselves more and more, and not everyone has that experience, but more and more, like, culturally it's very just like open, you're kind of like, you're here for it, and you're finally like, yeah, like, duh, now. And you might feel, a lot of you might feel very understood this month by people, regardless if they've actually said something to you. You may find that you draw in people that are way more on the same page as you. The one thing that you might come up against is that weighing out that passion and that impulse that you have. So this is right here. Remember what makes you stuck. What is your pattern? What gets you back to that place? Because that's not where you're going anymore. There's a maturity that's come over you, even in times when you want to be quote-unquote bad or do whatever. There's a purity that you have, and a purity in your nature that, like, can be badass if you learn to just say fuck you and just, like, be yourself. Libra season kind of washed that, like, okay, it's just time for you to be your fucking self, whatever that is, and give a fuck you to everything else. And that's the sexiest thing you could do. The fuck you finger, it's all about that for you this month. And to let yourself unleash when you feel like it, let yourself be tamed when you like, just let those two things, do those two parts of you, be a part of you this month in the ways that aren't going to keep you stuck. Like, don't fall into the traps, you know? Like, there's two, it's just so clear for you this month. It's so clear. Not everyone's going to have that experience. So know that you're going to look around and be like, what? And you're just very clear. It's just the veil so thin. There's so much more I would love to just, like, sit and talk to you about right now, but that is as far as we're going to go. I think that's perfect. Thank you so much for being here. I hope you have an amazing birthday season, and I'll see you next month, Scorpio. All information to work with me is below.